Hello there, and welcome to the Publishing Hour show today with Host Evangelist Jimmie Gyamerah, where we are here to inform you on how to write your book the right way the first time and so much more. Get ready for our wonderful show. The scripture for the week is as follows: Psalms 150, verse 4 and 6, King James Version. Praise him with the timbrel and dance. Praise him with string instruments and organs. Let everything that has breath praise the Lord. Praise ye the Lord. This week we are having a mind group. It's called Rhema, and it's with one of the local ministries here in Richmond, Virginia. This is one way you can find how you can worship the Lord with dance, and you're praising him with a dance or movement. So sit back and look at our show today. It's young adults here, and I am so excited because the first time I saw these young people, my spirit was just leaping all over the place. I was so excited. So I pray that you get that excitement in your spirit so you can go on and do what thus said the Lord. Stay tuned to the Publishing Hour show with Host Evangelist.
Is there anybody here that's been? This is Evangelist Jimmie with the Publishing Hour Show. And I am so glad you're watching the show today. We have an awesome, awesome treat for you. We have Janique Bennett here with Rhema, which is a mind group at Victoria's Living Christian Center. And that's a ministry here off of 9 Mile Road in Richmond, Virginia. And I just fell in love with them when I saw them. I had all this fire on me. I'm like, okay, Lord, what's going on? They were so awesome. So I want you to introduce yourself to our viewers and just tell us a little bit about yourself and how did you get into this ministry?
My name is Janique Bennett, as we spoke about earlier. And I got into it by Tiffany Foster. She started it, and then me and my family were interested in doing it, so we went to the first practice and fell in love with it ever since.
Amen, amen. So what is miming? I mean, we got people out here, and they're like, what is mime?
Miming, well, I think there's a lot of different, people have different views on miming,
okay?
But for us, it's more, it's an expression, but it's being considered, or called Rhema. We're trying to be the living word. You know, it's more of a, like I said, we want to have a meaning, we want to tell a story. I mean, not that other mimes don't do that, but for us, it's like, it's always just trying to live whatever song that we're miming or whatever story that we're miming.
Amen, amen. I found it so interesting as I was sitting there filming the rehearsal, and I noticed how you were teaching the young ladies and then the gentleman that came that particular story. And I thought it was so intriguing because I never actually sat back and really paid close attention to it. And I know it's people out there that want to have this in their ministry. How would you suggest for them to start?
To start, honestly, a lot of it, like I said, it started with Tiffany, and because she's done it for years and stuff. But as far as like just starting, sometimes you just gotta listen to music, feel the music, get an understanding of what they're talking about, and then what kind of message you want to give out, and then putting it to word or putting it to using your body to express what it is that you're trying to, whatever your message is.
So it's like dancing.
I wouldn't really call it dancing. Sometimes it can be kind of dancing. Sometimes you can stand there and just like I'm saying, that's not a dance. I'm just saying hi. So it's like it's the expression you give through your body.
And how does that coincide with ministry with God? Because you see miming out there, say it in New York Central Park. It's a mime. They just, they can't talk. You can't talk when you got your makeup on, and you're just moving. So, they just doing something and just expressing themselves. But how does that relate to the Word of God?
Either way you mime, it's all telling a story. Like, if you're in the box and you're trapped in the box, you're trapped in the box, you're trying to get out. People can understand through what your body's doing and your facial expression. Because if you're trapped in the box and you want to be there, you'd be like, you'd be happy. But if you're trapped in a box and you're kind of sad and you want to get out, you're going to be like, looking around, trying. It's all an expression. And when you're trying to do it toward, when you're trying to give a message behind it, that's just what really changes it. It's just the message that you're trying to convey in the story using your body.
And I've noticed how the anointing flows when you guys are dancing. Can you help someone that may be trying to get a mind team together, and how can they help with their minding, but yet worship in the glory?
Honestly, I would say if somebody's trying to get into the miming and you want to get a group together, it always starts with one person. A lot of times if somebody can see what it is that you're doing and they can feel what you're doing, then a lot of times that's just pretty much where it starts. And then if somebody was like, I don't know if I can do that, a lot of times it just takes just that little something, one time, and they'll end
done with one person or a group.
Yes.
Because you guys have a group.
Mm-hmm.
Now, to say one person, because I have a ministry that's interested in actually having a one person do it, and it's a child. So I know we talked, we got a little interviews with your daughters and the other young lady, and they were excited about it. They talked about it, and, you know, how it brought glory to the Lord. I'm so proud of them. And so this child, I think the child is about 9 years old. Can you look in the camera and just help that young man, or young, I think it's a young man, to start his mind?
Especially with them being at the age of nine, that's whenever you're less conformed and transformed by the world. So let the child be able to feel without having to have, you know, the headaches from the world and all that stuff kind of, you know, binding them down. Let them feel it. Whatever story he wants to tell or she wants to tell, let them tell it, and just, you know, like I said, be from the heart. Be from the heart, and you're feeling something, like you see God's trying to speak to you about, okay, this is the kind of message I want for the people to see through you. Listen to it. And there's nothing to be afraid of, because, you know, some people think, oh, you look kind of, no. Anything that that's done through God, there's no funniness about it. There's no, you know, weirdness.
Amen. Now help them transition from their face to the mind face.
Well, when you do the mind face, it's basically it's taking away all of you. So when you put it on, it's no longer you. It's the Spirit speaking through you.
Love that, because I noticed that you guys couldn't talk or anything, and you can't talk when you put the face on. Now, what type of makeup do you use?
Actually, it's just clown makeup. It's clown white makeup.
Clown white makeup, and then what? Just the white makeup, and
people do it different ways. I mean, some people, they cover the whole face and it's just white. They don't actually put like an actual face on. And then sometimes you can go to like Walmart, dollar store, and just get like regular like eyeliner, black lipstick, and like, you know, with an outline. But it all depends on what expression you're trying to make. And like I said, some people, it's just straight white. Because like I said, you're taking away yourself. So as long as you're taking away yourself, can pretty much add to your face whatever you want to add to it.
That's interesting. I never knew it was clown face or makeup. That is so cool. All right. Now, is there anything else would you like to tell our viewers on mining and your storytelling? Just something that would help them or that has helped you to actually get into that role?
Honestly, this is what I tell my daughters. I tell them, understand, like, whatever music you hear, whatever music you're listening to, feel it. If you don't feel what it is you're doing, then nobody else can feel what you're doing.
So they actually balance it off of you. Wow.
Like if you're supposed to be angry and you're just like, nobody's going to feel exactly what you're feeling. If you're not feeling it, you're not really truly conveying what it is that you need to convey. If you're supposed to be really happy, show it. Because some people they'll just, and you're not really getting anything out of that. Just like when you're watching a movie. You watch a movie and all the characters are just reading lines and they're not giving a full performance, you're not going to really feel and understand and get the whole full message.
Amen. Well, thank you for stopping here at the Publishing Hour show today.
answer?
It's midnight for her. You know, but when it comes to me, it's that time of day. You know, when it's you, it's a different story. But when it's somebody else,
so what are they doing?
They're supposed to be like this. They're like, right now, y'all supposed to be up standing. Because you got to listen for your part to come in again. Because it's going to come, it's going to be, but you
get up.
I kind of need them familiar to listen. I'm going to try to run it through enough for you to see. And I'm going to stop.
All this right here is me.
You're being
Yeah.
You gonna, what you do, is you come and you touch her. There you go. See, people listening. No,
not
now. Is that somebody? So what you do is... No, Jake, what are you doing?
Yeah, that hurts.
I didn't tell you to get it. No, I'm not talking about y'all. I'm talking about this.
How you doing?
So when you're coming, you're talking to me. That's where we're having our conversation. Like, I know you're there,
okay.
And I acknowledge you, but then I don't. Then at times I'm like, I push you away. So what you're doing during that time is you come over. She's the doctor.
Go ahead, get position real quick.
I got it. So basically, I'm encouraging you through it, but I'm also sort of talking. I'm talking through the whole thing. Like, y'all are the scenery, but I'm.
Mm-hmm.
I got it.
So, what you're going to do when it comes to them? Because, like, she's like, get back down.
Yeah.
So that she's not on for too long. Because, like, when you say, or because she's going to be late. Go back. Maya, get over here. This is not cute. So she's over here and she's what you doing? You're doing this, you know, Maya, that's not funny. You come over, you touch her. And then when she touches her, because she's gonna have her hands off of her at the moment, you're gonna touch her, and when she touches her, then she's gonna come up. And then y'all go ahead and get up and get y'all position. And then she's gonna come to me. And you'll be like this, and you're like, but you only call when you're, you know.
So, and you have to tell me, at what point in the song am I doing all that? So what point
you
going to
hear emergency. Like, I came on, because when you're in emergency, I came on a double. And then, that's when you're going to call an emergency. I came on a double, then you're going to touch her.
Okay, emergency double, that's when I touch her.
Mm-hmm.
And then when do I do what next? After I touch her, then I do what?
Oh, then you just, you know, you continue to talk to me, like, I'm still here.
I'm still
like, you're
you.
Like, you basically.
But then that's when you say, oh, she's healed, so now back.
Yeah,
okay.
We're at Victoria's Secret Living Center. No.
Victoria's Secret?
What's the name of it again? Okay.
Victoria's Living Christian Center.
We're at Victoria's
Christian
Living Center. And we have some of the ladies here that are with the Rhema. Is that the name of it? All right. Now what I want you to do is say your name. And how did you get into Rhema?
Miami?
Yes.
Okay. My name
Speak
is,
up loudly.
My name is Kwamisha Baptist, and I got into miming by, as you can see, my VLCC family. They showed me how to mime and how to practice mime, and I like it, so I started doing mime.
Okay. What's your name? Speak a little loud now.
My name is Joe Bennett, and I got into miming from my mom. And Miss Tiffany.
Your mom and who else?
Miss Tiffany.
Okay.
My name is Deja Bennett. I found out from my miming from my mother and my sisters.
Okay.
And Miss Tiffany.
Okay.
Hi, my name is Tamaya Bennett.
I'll go loud.
Hi, my name is Tamaya Bennett. I learned from miming is from my mom, my sisters, and my Miss Tiffany.
Okay.
My name is Tara Bennett. I learned the miming from my mom and my big sisters.
All right. Now, how well do you all like it? Now, if it's some more kids that want to get into mining, what would you suggest for them to think about? Who want to answer that one? Okay.
It would be cool to let more people, more kids and stuff inside the mime, because then you all know like more kids will understand.
Okay, they understand. What else?
And that they would know that miming is a great word for God.
All right. Anybody else, the older girls?
You seriously got to practice your facial expressions. You need to know how to work your body to the words.
Okay. No one? All right. Thank you, ladies, for stopping in today with the Publishing Hour Show here with Evangelist Jimmie. And you all are going to teach others how to mine. Now, what is the purpose of mining? Do you all understand the purpose of mining?
Mining is like where you have to mime and you have to feel the motion that you're trying to do. And when you're doing it, you have to get the people into listening to it, and then they can feel it.
Okay, they're feeling it with the Holy Spirit that's moving inside of you.
It's like getting closer to God.
Amen.
And if you mind, it's going to go in the work of record. See, go up or down.
All right. Well, thank you, ladies. You all have a blessed day.
Oh.
Thank you for watching the Publishing Hour show, and I know you were blessed. I know you enjoyed our show today, but if you'd like to be a guest on the show, give me a call at 804-719-1526. That's 804-719-1526. And go online and pick up one of our inspirational books at www.joniquedesign.com. That's www.joniquedesign.com.